three, four.
First, we'll start by changing the wallpaper. Right-click on the desktop, select Change Desktop Background, and apply your favorite wallpaper. Next, we'll download the Orcus theme from GitHub. Head over to the website using the link in the description, click the green button, and download it as a zip file. On the GitHub page, you'll find all the installation instructions. This theme offers various color options, lets you make it even darker, and gives you the choice of Windows or macOS style buttons and more. Now, open the File Explorer and locate the theme you just downloaded. Right-click and extract the file. Your extracted folder should look something like this. Then open a terminal inside the extracted folder. To install the Orcus theme, run .install.sh command. And for selecting your preferred theme, enter -t, then type your color name. I'll choose purple since my wallpaper has a purple tone, but you can pick whichever color you like. For the button theme, I'll go with the macOS style buttons, but feel free to choose whatever suits your style. For that, type --tweaks space macOS and press enter. Now that our theme is installed, let's apply it. Search for themes in the applications menu and open it. At the bottom, click Advanced Settings. To change the application style, click Applications and select your newly installed Orcus theme. You can choose either the dark or light version based on your preference. Now you'll see that the application style has changed. Next, apply the theme for desktop. This will update your desktop elements, such as the application menu, panel styles, and widgets. Now, let's download some icon themes. Visit gnomelook.org. And on the left side, select Full Icon Themes from the category menu. Click on Rating at the top to sort by the best options. Find and download your favorite icon theme. For this tutorial, we'll be downloading the Telecircle icon theme. By clicking on the image, you can preview the icons before installing them. Be sure to check the theme's description to confirm it's compatible with your desktop environment. Next, click the Files option to proceed the download. We'll go with the purple version, so the folder icons will match that color. Let's go ahead and download it now. Extract the folder you just downloaded and open it. In another File Explorer window, open your home directory. Right-click and select Show Hidden Files. Look for a folder named .icons. If it's not there, you can create a new folder and name it .icons. Now open the .icons folder and copy or move the extracted icon theme folder into that folder. Now open the theming app and apply your new icon theme. For the best look, match the icon theme with your current setup. If you're using a light theme, apply the light version of icons. Our new icons are now in place, and the folders have turned purple. Here's a quick preview of the updated application menu. If you're not happy with the default cursor style, here's how to install new cursor themes. Head back to gnomelook.org, and this time select cursors from the category list. Find and download a cursor theme you like. Yeah, let's go with banana. Sounds fun, right? Let's download it. Once it's downloaded, extract the folder and move it to the .icons folder where you place the icon themes. Then, open the Themes app again and apply your new cursor. and here's our new banana cursor in action. Since this is just for demonstration, I'll switch my cursor back to the default. Next, let's change the button's layout. Open System Settings and look for the Windows option. From there, you can adjust the button layout. You can move the buttons to the left or right, keep just the close button, or even go for the classic macOS style. Now, let's change the Alt+Tab preview. Go to the Alt+Tab section in the Windows settings. You'll find a few different styles, just pick the one you like best. Now it's time to change the fonts. Head over to fonts.google.com and find your favorite font to download. If you want to change the font for your terminal or coding environments, apply the monospace filter on the left, as these fonts are designed for coding and terminal-based tasks. Pick a font you like. I'm going with Inconsolata because I love how the brackets look almost circular. Once you've made your choice, go ahead and download your favorite font. Extract your downloaded fonts and install them. Locate the TTF font file inside the folder and double-click it. You'll see an install button, just click it to install the font. It says installed for me since I already have it. If you're unable to open the font file, you need a font viewer software. Just open the software manager, search for GNOME Font Viewer, and install it. Now you should be able to see the install option when opening the font file. Once you've installed the fonts, open the menu and search for font selection to access the software. Next, you can change the font for each option as desired. For example, here's how my default font looks before and after the change. To apply the font for your terminal, click it, then select Preferences. Under the Profile section, you'll find an option for custom font. Check that box, then choose your newly installed font. You can also adjust the font size while changing the font. Now your terminal font is updated. Feel free to explore other options to customize your terminal even further. To change your panel style, right-click on the panel and open Panel Settings. Here you can adjust the panel size and change the icon and font sizes separately for the left, center, and right sections of your panel. You can also modify the panel visibility, choosing between Auto-Hide, Always Show, or Intelligently Hide option. To rearrange items on your panel, right-click and enable Edit Mode. This allows you to move items to the left, right, or center. You can also remove any items or applets you no longer need. If you're not happy with the default menu icon, right-click on it and select Configure. From there, you can easily set a custom icon of your choice. Now, let's add a few applets to our panel. Right-click on the panel and select Applets. You can download all the applets shown in the video by clicking the download option at the top. First, we'll add the Cinnamon Menu applet. This applet offers a grid-style menu that displays all your apps in a grid view instead of the default list. If you're not a fan of the default menu, you can replace it with this grid-style menu. Next, let's add the Workspace Switcher applet. This applet gives you a visual overview of all your workspaces or virtual desktops and allows you to switch between them easily. By clicking the little icon, you can access the applet's settings. From there, you can make it more compact by selecting the simple button option, which will only show the number of workspaces you currently have. Next, we have the Windows Quick List applet. If you use multiple workspaces, this applet will come in handy. It provides a list of all the software you have open across different workspaces, making it easier to keep track of everything. If you want to customize the clock style on your lock screen, like changing the font or time format, here's how to do it. First, of course, you'll need to unlock your computer. Once you're on your desktop, open the Applications menu and search for Screensaver. From there, you can find options to tweak the appearance of your lock screen clock. In the Settings, click on Customize. Here, you will find the option to adjust the font for the date and time, and enter your own custom date formats. If you don't have knowledge about date formats, click the Show Information button. This will take you to a website where you can find predefined date formats or even build your own. Simply drag the elements you want, copy the format, and paste it into the date or time section. You can also add custom text, like your name or a welcome message, to display on the lock screen. You're not limited to just date formats. I hope you found the video helpful, especially if you're just getting started with Cinnamon. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, and if you're new here, consider subscribing for more tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching.